Have you ever been to a fair and taken a ride in a Ferris wheel? Many human-made objects move in a circular motion. Many natural objects move in a circle as well, from a microorganism's flagellum to the orbits of planets. When an object such as a race car turns a corner, it is momentarily moving along a circular path. When an object moves in a circular path, it is accelerating. Consider yourself riding in one of these spinning teacups. As the cup moves around, its velocity is constantly changing. It is changing both speed and direction. As you move in a circle, you are being pulled towards the center of the circle. This pulling force is called the centripetal force. Without centripetal force, an object will move in a straight line. Centripetal force is the net force of an object moving in a circular path. The tension in the chains of these swings causes the people riding them to be constantly pulled towards the center to follow a circular path. Even if an object is moving at a constant speed around the perimeter of a circle, it's still always changing its velocity and acceleration. This is centripetal acceleration. The force of centripetal acceleration acting on a moving object depends on its speed and the radius of the circle on which it moves. Centripetal acceleration A is equal to the velocity of the subject V squared, divided by the radius of the circle R. Circular motion is the result of two balanced forces. Centripetal acceleration draws the object toward the center. This is balanced by tangential acceleration, which causes the object to move in a straight line tangent to the circle. The two acceleration vectors are perpendicular to one another. Centripetal acceleration causes a change in direction. Tangential acceleration causes a change in speed. If the velocity of an object changes at a constant rate, then it's subject to uniform acceleration. Plotted on a graph of velocity over time, uniform acceleration is a straight line. For example, the force of gravity imparts a uniform acceleration. If both centripetal and tangential acceleration are uniform, the object follows a perfectly circular path. The planets do not follow perfectly circular orbits as they circle the Sun, partly because of the gravitational pull the planets exert on each other as they orbit the Sun. This causes the planets to have non-uniform centripetal acceleration and tangential acceleration, so they follow elliptical orbits.